The views and comments expressed on Reach Around Radio by its hosts and their guests do not reflect the views of RMCOnAir.com, its affiliates, or other outlets. The preceding program may contain ratchet language, buffoonery, and raw humor, and is intended for mature audiences only. Listener discretion is advised.
Injection, fellas.
You know what it is. Motherfucking bored up. It's Reach Around Radio. It's Monday.
Gotta let the whole intro play.
Your family.
I will not.
Thank you, too.
It's Reach Around Radio. It's Monday. It's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog, in the motherfucking house. To all the beautiful ladies that got with me this weekend. Beautiful. Yeah, them too. Got with your boy this weekend. Had some shit happen. I'll tell you about it in a minute. I just want to let you know I had a grand time with you, and we got it in like this.
Gloria.
That was her name. My Gloria.
Go on, Speedy, get him.
Is this the original version?
We ain't brought you in yet. We ain't brought you in yet. Sit down.
You went away.
Pam, I'm looking at your hair. I'm saying,
Gloria.
I can't think of a food that matches with Gloria.
That's why I did.
I don't want to see
you. I'm going to take some volume on my mic. I think it's Speedy.
Wow. CJ from way down.
Wow. Turn, anyway.
Isn't it funny?
Glory hole.
Wrong verse.
Glory hole.
Ain't that a bit?
Yeah.
Glory hole.
You asked for it, Speedy. I just gave what you wanted.
Anyway, it's your boy, Speed Doggy Dog, in the house. What's happening?
I'm the poetess.
It's your girl, Claudia Jordan.
I'm TDP, Mr. 123 Knox.
Baby!
And whoa, Nelly, it's Keith Jackson. We got a barn burner. The Alabama Crimson Tide versus the Georgia Bulldogs in the SEC Championship.
Sorry, I had to get that out.
It's actually Notre Dame, but go ahead.
No, the SEC Championship.
Boom!
SEC,
yeah.
White boys in
he
the building.
RT or
anyway, who cares? In the house!
Wow!
You have a special guest.
Tell it!
How special?
Special guest.
Yeah, special.
He ain't got time for us heathens.
How disgusted he is. I'm like, why did I make this decision? All my agents.
From Compton, California.
CPT.
Mr. Anthony Anderson.
My agent. My agent doesn't even know I'm here.
Hilarious.
He told me to call him Mr. Anderson.
What's you know up, what, Anthony? Motherfucker, I got a bunch of choice words. I mean, it's crazy. I feel like I'm in the foxhole, but
well, you kind of, you're
because
out of
all
it.
Of y'all
we
got
were,
fired.
Right.
Wow. Really?
I'm going in right now. Let's talk about the firing.
Yes, because you know what? Our fans have been wanting. They ask us every week what happened.
What happened?
You know, because I'm not going to lie.
Okay.
Some of you, or at least one of you, deserve to be fired. And the rest was just collateral damage.
Yes.
Okay. All right, we're going
to. The motherfucker that needed to be fired, Speedy.
That's where we are now.
So, no. We're going in, right, motherfucker? Right now. So, loyal listeners. Dude. Loyal listeners and followers of this radio show.
Reach Around Radio.
Reach Around Radio.
Yes.
Speedy. Put together a Jamie Foxx weekend.
Oh,
we going there. Okay.
A Jamie Foxx weekend.
Anthony.
A Jamie Foxx celebrity.
Celebrity.
No. Yeah. I think I was the only celebrity there since Jamie Foxx didn't show up.
Okay.
And Jamie Foxx didn't show up because I really don't even think he knew about his own weekend.
Oh wow! Like
oh
that?
Shit.
So it was a Jamie Foxx celebrity weekend, which was supposed to be a Jamie Foxx celebrity softball game,
yes.
Followed by a comedy show,
correct.
Hosted by Jamie Foxx.
Correct.
Oh, wow. No, hosted by me.
No. Nobody's coming to see a show hosted by
within a
period.
Not that many people. Now, you know what? Now, hold on. It might have been supposedly hosted by Speedy, but it was the Jamie Foxx comedy whatever
correct.
Hosted by Speedy. Mm. Yes. And Jamie Foxx is supposed to be in the building.
Correct.
So,
which he would have been.
Which he wasn't. Mm. Because he had no knowledge of this entire weekend.
Oh, my goodness.
Yes, he did.
No, you don't. No, you don't have.
Go ahead.
You don't have knowledge of Jamie Foxx Celebrity Weekend. Mr. White Guy, can I call Mr. White Guy?
You're confide in me. It's
all
okay,
right. Listen.
Confide in me.
Okay, I will confide in the Ofay. So, okay. Mr. Ofay. So.
Token. I prefer token.
Okay, token. Token, look. If we are having a token weekend.
Yes. Hilarious.
And you are said token.
Mm. Yes.
A token celebrity weekend.
Well.
Quite naturally, the token would be there.
Yes, the token now would have to be there. Oh, thus, okay. The celebrity token weekend.
There you go. So, Jamie, being the token, was not even aware of what was going on. You want to know how I know this?
How you know, Anthony?
Because I called Jamie and asked him.
You talked to Jamie.
I talked to Mr. Foxx himself, and he said, Anthony, I really don't know what the fuck you're talking about. And I was like, I only came to Houston. I only came to Air Phoenix to play in this Jamie Foxx celebrity softball game because it's called the Jamie Foxx celebrity softball game, not the Speedy Calm and his friends right. Come play tag with me in the park while I use Jamie Foxx's name to make money.
Wow. Oh, damn. Stop saying
that. So.
So.
It's accurate to me.
So, mind you, I'm not long-winded. This is just how long the story is.
Correct. It's a long story.
The manager of the venue comes to me.
Yes, he did.
I'm the only recognizable face. Actually, you didn't see him at this particular point because you were on the freeway driving from Los Angeles to Phoenix. So the manager of the venue, because I flew there, came to me and was like, so what are we going to do? Now, mind you, there was a Foxxhole a radio show live that was going on in the theater.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I saw that.
Mind you, there were hundreds upon hundreds of people waiting for Jamie Foxx and the Foxxhole to show up. Nobody showed up. Walking through to do a walkthrough and see where the venue was. They thought I was a part of the show.
Mm.
So we're sitting there, we're calling Speedy. Speedy, where you landing? Man, I'm landing right now. We find out he ain't landing no damn place because the motherfucker drove.
I never told you I flew.
I'm landing at the
gas station. You didn't tell me I flew. You told somebody else flew.
I never did.
And you were driving.
Okay. Dang, you just really pissed
me. Okay, that's okay. I will give you that. I will give you that lie. I'll take that lie back.
Okay. Okay, so Speedy was landing.
No, but that was around the time he was on tour, so he very well might have said he was flying.
Oh, what kind of tour?
When he's on tour, it's when he wears the new clothes, new sneakers, the kids don't eat, but he's like dressed.
Oh, okay.
Damn!
The self. So, mind you, we're at the softball game. We're playing softball.
Right.
The manager of the venue had already come to me and was like, man, I'm losing so much money. These people paid money to sit in these seats to do this live Foxxhole show.
Mm.
They do the live Foxxhole show. It's not even live.
Oh,
we're not even broadcasting anywhere. Uh-oh. We got mics on the stage.
Speedy, defend yourself.
We got.
Can't get away.
And you want to know how I know it wasn't broadcast live?
Oh, it wasn't broadcast.
Because the dude turned on Fox, the Foxxhole. No, it was a rerun of a previous show.
Hysterical.
So we sit here. These people think they are live. You say what, Kelly?
Was it Stacey Dash show? On?
Show on? I don't know what it was. One of those other shows was on.
That didn't make it.
Hysterical.
So that's what happens when he lands. The next day, we go to the softball game.
Correct.
Speedy comes to me
Let's
and
go
writes.
Softballs.
He goes, no, that's softball. We're playing for the babies. Speedy comes to me and says, hey, Anthony.
I can do this part. Ant.
Okay, do it.
I said, Ant.
Hilarious.
I said, Ant, can you do me a favor? Anthony goes, hail. No, and I need to see the bank receipts.
Exactly. Because I already know what the favor is because the manager done been on me for 16 hours.
Wow.
But that's not what happened, though.
Okay, whatever.
But go ahead.
Okay, so we play softball.
I like your Beijing 7.
Thank you, baby. We play safeball, softball. I come back to the casino in the hotel where we're staying. I still got softball dirt on me.
Yes.
I haven't eaten all day.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So I go to the restaurant to sit down with my boy.
Oh, that shit.
There is an 8x10 photo of me where Jamie Foxx's photo used to be.
I saw that.
Around the entire casino.
I saw that.
Switcheroo. In the hotel rooms, on the TV, in the elevators, all this big Jamie Foxx weekend, picture of Jamie Foxx. We're gone 6.5 hours playing softball. They switched out all of Jamie Foxx's pictures, downloaded a picture of me in a pink shirt
to the Anthony Anderson
put me
weekend.
In there, and it becomes the Anthony Anderson weekend that Jamie Foxx has not ever never knew about.
Right.
Mind you, again, Speedy, Anthony, man, I really need your help.
Yeah.
Can you just host the show?
Just say a few words.
And bring I host
me,
it.
And bring me on so we can.
Was he
please,
a Scat Brother Crothers voice?
Please. He had one tear in his eye. Oh, and I was like, you know what? I can't back out now, Token. You want to know why? Because everybody around the hotel now sees my picture as hosting the extravaganza of like comedy.
Like you might be backing out.
Exactly. So now I can't back out because people are coming up to me saying, man, had I known it was your show, I would have bought 10 tickets.
Wow.
Wow.
So now I got
to. So are you saying you were more of a draw than Jamie Foxx?
That's, possibly.
I think he didn't say that.
Allegedly.
I just said, they said if they knew it was mine, they would have bought 10 tickets.
10 tickets. Oh. Moving on with
that's
the story.
That's all I'm saying. That's what the one person told me.
It's the first time I heard the truth.
So. Well, I'm living the truth. I don't know what the fuck you were living that weekend. Wow. So now I'm like, all right. We go backstage. I said, okay, Speedy, I'll do this for you. He said, thank you, Anthony. He's very apologetic. Thank you, man. I really do appreciate this. I owe you one, man. Thank you for doing this for me. I said, nigga, I'm not doing this for you.
I love
you. I'm doing this because my pictures are posted around on the elevators.
I'm screwed.
And they did take care of me.
Hold on. I'm going to get to how they took care of me.
Okay, cool.
So
okay.
I do the show.
Roll.
Who got tickets?
Now, mind you, I go up there. No material, no nothing. Did I rip the shit for you, Speedy?
You did that.
You did great.
I did.
TDP, did it.
I was impressed.
Then maybe high 15, high 20.
You did
yes,
that.
Yes, you did it.
Then brought Speedy on. No, I mean, I had them on their feet. I got them into an uproar.
I saw that.
They were ready.
They was ready.
Open.
And then Speedy came on, did his thing. And then we had, the show went off without a hitch.
So it was good.
Oh, it was a hot comedy show.
Yes, it was.
Okay. Hot comedy show. And sold out, I might add.
Sold out.
Yeah. Wow.
So now we're at the after party.
Somebody made money.
Starring Anthony Anderson.
Yeah, somebody made money.
You know?
Okay.
Speedy walking around like, man, they going to sue me. How they going to sue you? Hey, they made money. That. It was a sold out house.
Yes, no, sir. He was actually, the white dude was happy.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know. What was that to Uncle Tom?
We prefer Token.
Who are we talking about?
The Uncle Tom, the brother. There was a white dude and there was a brother.
And the brother.
The brother was the one that was stressing out.
Yeah, yeah. The white dude was happy. He wanted us to come back.
Yeah, yes, exactly.
I thought it was awesome.
So we're in the after party for this show, for this whole Jamie Foxx extravaganza weekend.
Slash.
Slash what?
Yo.
Slash Anthony. Wait, throw me. They know I'm a part of it already. So we're in there. Grooving, ladies, popping bottles. The two dudes, the white dude and the black dude who were managing the venue, came to me and said, Anthony and Speedy, Anthony, we wanna. Can you come to the office with us for a second?
Because
they had been promising to take care of me.
Yes. Right.
And they were like, no, we're going to really take care of you.
And Anthony came in going, I better be getting taken care of.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'm not coming back here.
Exactly. Mind you, because it's sold the fuck out.
Yes, it is.
Sold out.
These motherfuckers open up a drawer and go in and start getting some cash, but they're pimping it like, you know, they're really about to break a motherfucker off.
Right. Like they bring out the big wad.
They went in here and said, Anthony, we this is what he said. Anthony, we want to thank you for saving our night. And as a token, you know, we really want to take care of you. We can't get you because I don't know what's going on. Nigga, right. I was like, nigga, the house was sold out. What you mean? He said, no, we got you. Broke me off $500.
Wow.
I was right.
And some bottles of champagne.
500. Fuck them bottles of champagne. Yeah. I had already bought my own bottles.
And that's what he said. Anthony said, I just bought a whole round of
bottles. I said, I bought my own bottles, but this is how I pimped them.
So he proudly gave me $500.
Proudly gave me $500. This is what I did. I pulled out 10 grand of my own money and said, you know what? I'm going to put this with this.
Big bang, take a little bang.
I'm going to put this with this, brother. Thank you. And I was very condescending and very real with the shit. I was like, Thank you for the $500.
I can't believe they gave you the Tom and Jerry. Pull out the whole cake, give you the slice.
Yo, it was some bullshit. And oh, I had to tell the. I know it was long winded story. I had to tell y'all all this because everybody that was involved that was on the Foxxhole got fired the next fucking week.
Speak
when
on.
They like, came to work.
Down with the ship.
And all they did was accompany motherfucking Speedy to Phoenix.
Yes, sir.
All they did was accompany this motherfucker. They ain't worth no shit. They came to play softball.
Correct.
And had some fun in Phoenix. What did they get? They got a fucking pink slip. Not a 2 week notice. No, motherfucker, you're fired Tuesday.
We won't be needing your services.
Speedy was the only motherfucker that should have got fired.
Wow, the truth.
Speedy,
comes
your retort.
The truth comes out at
Speedy, your retort.
So you're the Titanic.
So all I need to know is how did Jamie Foxx not know about a Jamie Foxx weekend in Phoenix
and softball game?
Wow.
And why is he gonna say I had nothing to do with that and no knowledge of that when I call the nigga and say, nigga, I'm in Phoenix. Where are you?
The plot thickens. The plot thickens.
That's not what happened.
That's
scrambled
what happened.
Eggs and M.
What happened? I'm going to take my headphones off so I can really hear.
Oh, wow. Girl.
That's not what happened.
What happened, happened, Speedy?
That's not what happened.
Oh, this is okay. The people's car right here. Go ahead, Speedy.
Hilarious.
Speedy.
The truth and Speedy's version.
Would you like...
go ahead, Speedy. Speedy
can. The floor is yours.
Mm.
You think?
You didn't interrupt me, so I'm not going to interrupt you.
Really, nigga? That's...
Tell your story.
Anyway, that's not what happened.
Wow.
Fox said, look, I'll do the softball weekend. I said, well, I'm attaching a comedy show with that. Do your thing. And we're going to do the Foxxhole there. Do your thing. Other entities, management, them little short motherfuckers.
Are you saying Guy Black and Greg
Yes,
Calvin?
Guy Black at the last minute, matter of fact, on that Thursday told me, well, I don't think you're going to be able to do the radio show. I said, my man, I've already cleared this with you guys 2 weeks earlier. What the fuck's going on? Well, I got to talk to Marcus. He hadn't talked to Marcus about doing the show. So I'm pretty much thrown under the bus, so I got to do it. So when I see you, I said, look, Anthony.
Let me stop you. I ain't had nothing to do with the radio show. Now, because you said we're not going to be able to do the radio show. Now, you talking about the comedy show or the radio show?
Some of the whole weekend. We just go the whole week.
So the radio show
I did ask you
and
come do
the
comedy
show.
I did ask you to come do the radio show as well.
Yes, you did.
I did.
Girl.
And I said, Anthony
Perry.
Anthony kept going, I'm going to need to get paid. He made, didn't they pay for your drinks?
$500.
Paid for, not the $500.
What drinks, nigga? I bought my own drinks in the
club. But you made them pay
I had bottles already on my table when they came to me.
Girl.
Even before
didn't
the club,
you
man,
in?
You bought us shots at the...
nigga, you flew me in on Southwest for $89.
You said it was cool.
I ain't got a problem with that, but nigga, you said, didn't I flew it? Nigga, like you said, the jet.
Want to get away?
Mr. Anderson, we've chilled these bottles of Boone's Farm. Would you like
peanuts?
I do appreciate you coming through for me.
No, I had motherfucker.
And the white boy said,
"Your room with the days in is available."
The European said, "Hey man, I'm sorry about this whole mix-up, but the show was great. Can y'all come back?"
But hold on. Where did all the money? Who made the money that weekend?
They did. I didn't make sure.
Wow.
I paid everybody.
Don't mind my new sneakers. I had these.
That's why I was back there. I didn't get paid because Cedric took all the money.
Oh, my goodness.
Wait, no. Hold on now.
Cedric didn't get no money.
Ced did get money.
No, Ced didn't get no money.
Ced's the one took the heat.
Cedric the Entertainer?
Ced took the hit. Ced was mad in the club because he didn't get none. Ced didn't make no money. That's why we was balling out in the motherfucking club afterwards. I was like, nigga, I got you. Don't worry about it. I'm buying bottles for us.
You did that.
Yeah, TDP was right there.
You did that.
I ain't know that about it. I didn't make no money on that.
Nigga, I didn't. I lost money.
No, you made $500.
You made $500.
Do you know what my quote is? I lost money.
That's like a low end video, right?
It was hard.
Damn.
I said it was hot.
Southwest got you there.
I did have fun.
You made
game
it.
Was hot.
But I did receive my last and final.
And then Poetess was so weird. Poetess is like an end around. She goes, so Speedy. I'm like, what's up, E? I don't think I'm not on the show anymore. I think it's because I went to Phoenix. I'm like, no, it has nothing to do with it. Fuck that. That's what it is. Click. Hello. Hello.
Well, I mean, this is a testament. The four of you that I'm staring at right now, three of you were in Phoenix.
Right.
Oh, I was fired pre.
She was fired.
Yeah, I understand that.
Yeah.
And I want to talk to you about some off off air about some other shit that you went through while you were there.
Oh, yeah. Yes, let's.
Yeah, please.
Let us pray. Let's talk about this shit.
So three motherfuckers that were there.
I didn't do nothing either.
Yeah. Didn't have a job when they got back to L.A. That's all I know.
Exactly. Right.
Now, of the three, I voted for one of the motherfuckers off.
Okay.
I voted for one off.
And who would that be?
I'm staring at him. This is what we call collateral damage. Guilty by association.
But let's keep it perfectly clear. At the time that we did this show, we were already on hiatus. They had told us we weren't. They didn't know what was coming back.
Oh, so that's where there was a rerun show airing when we were supposed to be live on the stage?
There were rerun shows running all for a month.
I get that. But it was supposed to be a live show because that's how it was billed to the people.
Yes, it was.
Yeah. And I walk in and,
So
it's live in the room.
Hey, good to have you here, Anthony.
So what else have you been up to?
I have to say this because, you know what, this is the first time that Speedy and I have talked about it since the incident.
Are you serious?
Stop, Anthony. Stop.
Speedy, when have we spoken about this?
When my man was supposed to hire you for that gig.
Oh, Lord. Don't do it.
The gig that didn't happen?
The gig that didn't happen.
Talking about white shoes after Labor Day.
Damn.
Speedy, the gift that never starts giving.
The gig that... Oh, that gig.
That guy.
Yeah, the gig that never starts giving. We briefly did talk about this, but we didn't talk about it in detail with an audience.
Oh, the Vegas show.
Yeah,
the Vegas magic disappearing show.
So, all you team R.A.R.
Nobody knows about that.
Yes, sir.
Because dude folded up his... Poof. Man, it's...
Damn, Speedy, we gotta get you, like... We gotta do some clearing before we
clear Speedy.
Oh damn, really?
There's nothing but death and destruction wherever he goes.
Speedy,
what's that? Sage. We need to burn some sage.
Burn some sage. No, fuck that. Burn Speedy.
Oh, so we have a caller.
I am not Sage.
Caller, what's your name and where you calling from? And where are you at the Phoenix show?
Who is this?
Caller.
Hey, this is J-Lip.
Hey, J-Lip.
Hey, I got to call in and say, first off, much love to Reach Around Radio. Y'all been killing this shit from day one.
Thank you.
True that. True that.
And this representing Columbus, Ohio. I've been trying to get on the damn internet and sneaking it from my damn neighbors on that hood wireless shit, but
I
finally got it.
Nigga, get dial up. Shit.
So I'm in here and them dumbasses named it password one. Finally got that shit. So now... I'm on here. I got to tell you, Claudia, you've been doing big things.
Thank
OG Poetess, I called earlier.
Thank
TDP, killing it. RG, killing
Speak
it.
Speak on it.
CD. Well, ain't
that a bitch.
Anthony Anderson, dog, I got to show you much love, man, because you've been representing for them big, light-skinned niggas like myself.
Appreciate it.
You know, even though you got a gap like Michael Strahan Jr., I still got love. All good.
Hey, J-Lip, nigga, you done already snitched on yourself, nigga. Your neighbors are going to change the password.
They're going to put a 2 on it.
It's going to be 1-2.
Right, it's got the wireless now.
Got the wire. Oh, okay, cool. You in the game.
Thank you, J-Lip.
Hey, I want to tell everybody up there much love. Anthony Anderson, you doing your damn thing, bro. Last but not least, got to say what up to DJ Always, killing it. I don't know if he there right now with the whole...
He giving you the peace sign right now, pimp.
Yes, sir.
Okay,
always in you.
That whole foxhole destruction that occurred, y'all niggas going to outshine them niggas. I don't know what's going on, Marcus King, Jamie Foxx, whatever, but y'all keeping it moving, and I'm going to keep tuning in, and I need my 2 t-shirts because I just donated
$50. Oh, it's coming.
All right, it's on the way. It's in the mail.
They're coming, but might I suggest do not wash them.
Put them in the cleaners.
Hey, y'all take it easy, man.
Appreciate you.
Thank you, J-Lip. That's what's up, baby.
Sun-dry, J-Lip. Sun-dry.
Carla, what's your name and where you calling from?
Sun-dry.
I'm serious. I don't wash them.
Wash them. Just spin on them.
Hey, Jay Nasty.
Wait, hold up, Jay Nasty. Hold up, Jay Nasty. Hold up.
Hey.
We got a feature for you right now. So every time you call, we're going to give you a little bit of this.
Why are we giving this nigga a theme song?
It's Jay Nasty.
I ain't going to teeter.
Oh, Lord.
I love him. But she's never been loved before.
Very good.
What?
All right. What's up, Jay Nasty?
Wow.
What's good? What's good to all the fam?
First, what's up,
the only reason why I'm calling in because my man's Anthony Anderson is in the building. Stand up. You know what I mean? Look, only reason why I watch the show, Guys with Kids, is because of you, fam. I'm talking about from you Also, Tempest Bledsoe, which is Marnie. Also, your kids, Yoda and Clark. You know what I mean? That shit is hilarious only because of you guys.
Thank you, brother. And
hopefully, one day, I can't remember old girl name, the divorced little chick, Aaron, or something like that.
Yeah, whatever. Aaron Hayes.
Yeah, hopefully, you know what I'm saying, you curse that bitch out one day. You know what I'm saying? That would be hilarious. Yes, but that's it, man. The show is great to go. Also, they've been running, what is that, Malibu's Most Wanted?
Yeah.
They've been running that all weekend, done.
Yeah, man, nah, I've been hearing good about it. They've been tweeting about it. Yeah, that's a good one, man. You know, that's one of the few films that still holds up to this day that I've been a part of.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Man, God bless, man. You are one of the most talented motherfuckers out there. Also, you can be hood when you want to. Also, Dunson, you can be
Dunson
when Dunson you need to. So,
thank you, brother.
I appreciate that. Like,
but he said, God bless and motherfucker.
And yeah. And he's still on the phone.
Yeah.
It is what it is. I'm Audi 5000. Hey!
That's what's up, baby.
That was a call from Jay Nasty with his own music there. Right here on Reach Around Radio.
Let's call it with a theme song.
Yeah.
You have another caller?
Oh, Lord, no. So, Anthony, what else have you been
up to? Yeah, how's the show doing?
Show's doing all right. Show's doing all right. We got picked up for, you know, our back, can't call it back nine. Nope. They picked us up for four.
Okay.
It's the back half. Yeah. The back half of now, nine.
Is that a goal when you go in to shoot these things that you want to get them picked up?
No, you just want to do one an hour.
What kind of question is that?
I'm just trying to make talk.
It's a question that
that's a dumb white boy question.
I mean, it's a question that he doesn't worry about. You know, he's privileged. You know how they are.
Right.
Yeah, I just want to let you know, that's Little Romney up there.
Yeah, no. The goal is to get the show picked up.
But that's what I mean beforehand. Like, when you go in to make the pilot, you're like, yeah, this motherfucker's gonna get picked up.
If not, it's a failure, motherfucker. I mean, what the fuck?
But you don't know shooting it, do you? You don't know. You know what I mean?
No, you don't. I mean, you know, the goal is always to get it picked up, but you don't know what's going to happen because the network shoot 20, 30 shows, and they only have slots for maybe four or five.
Right.
You know, so you just it's just the luck of the draw and what, you know, the network deems worthy and what they want to go with. And, you know, fortunately for us, our show was one of those. We got picked up for 13 out the gate, which is the biggest order that you can get nowadays.
There you go. Beautiful.
And, you know, we were going for that back nine. They picked us up for four. So, you know, FOMO is better than no mo.
That's for sure.
That's what I say. So, you know, it looks good for us to get picked up for the rest of the five. So, you know, we're confident. We're happy.
Good.
And then you just keep your fingers crossed for next season, right?
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly. You know, you get one season at a time.
You guys great have show. An audience or no audience?
Yeah, live audience. Live, okay. Tuesday nights.
Of all your projects, your movies, your TV shows, like, do you have a favorite? Like, one that you just had the best time on?
Television would be The Shield.
Oh, I love that show.
Yeah, it would be The Shield because that was the opportunity that I've been wanting to get that I finally got, you know, to show the world my dramatic skills. And
that show was incredible.
You know, get to play opposite Glenn Close and Michael Chiklis for a season, and then the following season opposite Michael Chiklis and Forrest Whitaker. So
the scene I'll never forget on that show when the police chief got
he had to give head.
To give dome, and he was all traumatized. It looked so real.
Yeah, it was gritty.
It was great acting.
It was gritty.
Now tell the story about Law and Order when they asked you to shave.
Oh, you know, man, they called us. You know, we have
the whole crew, right?
No, just me and Jeremy Sisto.
Because they had the beard.
Yeah, we had our beard. And you know the so we got called into. We have a table read, so it's just me and Jeremy Sisto and the producers who read our shows every week. Just because nobody's ever at work at the same time, so we read the script in sections. Mm-hmm. So we were there, and they were like, "Dick Wolf is on the phone for you guys, so we're going to step out of the room."
Shit.
And Dick's going to talk to you. Now we didn't know what the fuck was going on.
But it wasn't good.
Yeah, it didn't seem like it was going to be good because everybody left, and so it was just me and Sisto sitting in there. Like, what the fuck? Right.
Pink slips.
And so he says, guys, first off, I just want to tell you, you're doing a great job, which is normally what you hear right before they get rid of you. Right? And so we're like, he was like, but the beards have got to go.
Wow.
And after that, you know, I was like, oh, shit, whew, the beard. Oh, shit, when do you want me to shave this motherfucker?
Got magic shaving my pocket.
Yeah, so, but he was like, yeah, you know. I was like, who doesn't like it? He was like, well, this and that. I was like, no, well, who, motherfucker? This is how I'm talking to Dick. I was like, who, motherfucker, who doesn't like the beards now? And then it finally comes out that his wife didn't like the beard.
Wow.
Just say your wife didn't like it.
Wow. Are you serious? Wow.
And we'll shave him. You know, he tried to blame it on the police chief. I was like, motherfucker.
Well, this
this
been
is
a movement.
This is TV.
Real? This motherfucker not real.
This is TV. He was like, well, if they were my station, they get written up till they wrote it up. Motherfucker, we're not in your station. We're on a make-believe station.
Can't
but
believe
I understand.
Wife.
Happy wife. A happy wife makes a happy life, man. Yeah. Happy wife, maybe. It's a new tongue. So we shaved it. But the thing was, you know, they hired Jeremy Sisto because he's the pretty white boy.
Gotcha.
You know, and from the beginning, Jeremy never really wanted to play into that role. Mm-hmm. So he started growing his beard and scruff.
Rug, yeah.
Yeah, and just look, you know, all frumpy and all that. That was his thing.
Uh-huh.
And Dick Wolf hired me with a beard. Mm-hmm. We had a meeting, and he was like, yo, I want you to replace old boy. I was like, okay, cool. And so for a year and a half, I rocked the beard. For a year or so, I rocked the beard, and all of a sudden, he wants to shave it. What they were trying to do, they were trying to get Jeremy to become pretty again.
Oh, and they want you in on it.
Yeah, well, they didn't want me in on it. They just didn't want to go to him and be like, shave. He's like, no, both of you motherfuckers got to shave. And to Jeremy's defense, Jeremy was like, look, Dick, if you want me to shave my beard, I'll shave my beard, man. But Anthony shouldn't have to shave his.
Yeah.
Wow.
You know, so I'll shave my beard if that's what you want. And Dick was like, nah, you both got to shave it.
My wife is here. Shave it.
You know what I'm saying? So we're like, we just can't shave this motherfucker right now, Dick. I mean, so they wrote it into the script. You know, so we got to rock our beard for about 2 more weeks.
The two go for a shave.
And exactly.
And on their way to a shave, exactly. They saw a murder.
Serious shop.
Barbershop shave.
We shaved each other. It was the same.
Oh, this is got interesting.
But that was the shave sequence. And then, you know, that was it.
Cool.
Okay.
If you have a question for Anthony Anderson, you can call us at 323-965-1600.
Hey, how
people
you
in the chat said they feel bad for you,
Speedy. Oh, I ain't tripping. How come you never did any more Transformers?
Wow. Ask Michael Bay that shit.
Because you killed.
I thought I did.
You killed that shit.
I mean, I don't understand how the fuck gets back, invited back, when I'm the motherfuckers that decoded this shit and sent the planes to save the world.
You saved the fucking planes.
You did all the work and the little singer boy.
Yeah, they bring that motherfucker back for 2 and 3.
Wow.
Mm. I don't understand it. They actually brought a motherfucker back that died in the opening sequence of the original Transformers.
Maybe just pretend like he didn't get stepped on.
Yeah, he was great. Bring your beard back. They'll put the beard in the middle.
Shit. I hear they're doing Transformers 4 right now with Mark Wahlberg.
Now, can you call and say, hey, what the fuck?
Or I did call and say, hey, what the fuck? And he was like, not doing it.
Oh, wow. Ouch.
Just like that?
Just cut and dry. Yeah, no, my folks called and he wasn't responsive. But Mike was cool.
And we're going in a different direction.
Yeah. We're going to bring back all the dead
Michael
people.
Michael Strahan in here.
Yeah, get Strahan in here.
We got a white guy that can
somebody
be
more light skin.
We're going to bring Tyrese back, see if we can put him on the Transformers soundtrack.
Yeah, wow. Now, you sing a song about Transformers.
You did have your one movie that was you. Which was...
Yeah, and I haven't had one since.
Yeah, well, you want to talk about it? You want to later?
Well, actually, no. I mean, you know, I was good in it. King's Ransom,
King's
you're talking about.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, actually, King's Ransom is
now, is it your goal to have one movie, and then that's it?
Yeah, that's it. Make enough off of one, you fucking hang around with tokens the rest of your career. You know, unfortunately, the studio didn't believe in the movie.
Mm. Okay. I thought it was funny.
No, it's a hood classic. I mean, people, they dig it, you know, but... They didn't get behind it and produce it. We had the wrong director.
You got my mic. That's what it is.
Who directed it?
Yeah. Jeff Bird.
Oh,
I know. Friend of mine who I fought for to get the job. Mm-hmm. And then once we were working, and what I'm saying right now, I've told him.
Yeah.
I just wasn't the right guy.
Wow.
Just wasn't the right guy.
How far into it did you know it or feel that?
Soon.
Oof.
Soon.
3 pages?
And cut. We need a new guy.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it's like, Jeff Bird got the job. Damn, I didn't really want him to get the job.
Hysterical.
I mean.
Where's Billy Woodruff?
Yeah, no, but, so but that's how. Who the fuck is this coming in with it?
Oh, shit. The Wayans boys.
Oh, so Marlon is in the building.
You said boys, this one.
No, I just said the ball motherfucker was John Amos coming through here.
Hysterical.
John Amos.
I know it's meathead. I didn't know who the fuck was it.
In the building.
In the hypertension shirt. This is that, baby.
In the building.
Marlon
Wayans.
Yes, sir.
Welcome to Reach Around Radio.
Board out.
Oh, look at Togan giving up his eye.
Oh, Marlon, you know what I want to ask you?
The only white man out, that's fucking
good. He ain't going nowhere, trust me.
He ain't going nowhere.
All
right.
He owned all the equipment.
If he go, he going to take his equipment back with him. Give me my shit back.
You can have the headphones.
Yeah, we're on his dad's credit card.
Sennheiser, these ain't beat by Dre's.
Hysterical.
Absolutely not.
Anything else but beat by Dre's on the air.
Marlon Wayans in the building.
What's happening?
What's up?
Hey.
Good. Now, y'all niggas got applause and everything.
Before, can I ask you a question, Marlon?
They got sound effects.
They got some real shit.
Damn.
They ain't even got people to call in.
Y'all even got the bodyguard interviewing niggas.
Marlon, way downtown, bang.
Who little baby is this? For everybody to run. Get your ass. You gonna engineer. Mama, I'll not do. You gonna engineer. You play video games.
Push
you can
button.
Engineer, little nigga.
Anybody here random and unrecognizable is one of Speedy's family members.
I see.
Hysterical.
Like the uncle that just got out of jail over there in the funeral jacket.
Well, Marlon,
he got that jacket you bury people in.
Hey, Marlon, I'm following the You all right, though?
No, that was a great line.
I was dying on that one.
I was hiring family because, you know, I used to work at your brother's show, so I know how it's done.
Yeah.
Let's move on.
Yes, good man. Hey, he used to work with us on Wayne's Brothers.
I'll
forget that, huh?
Man, that was a great
time. Those crowds, though. That was fun, man.
That was a great time.
He's warming up for you guys, too?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Speedy is making that money.
Yeah. Mm.
Then he went to jail, but yeah.
Yo, I heard a great... What's your real name?
Not fast good.
Donald Coswell.
I heard this story literally 2 days ago.
Yeah. Story.
Motherfucker was telling this story. They were like, you was in jail, and a motherfucker walked up to you and was like, yo, man, is your name Donald Coswell?
Caldwell.
What's the last name? Is your name Donald Caldwell? He was like, yeah. He said, nigga, there's another Donald Caldwell on the other yard. He was like, no, nigga, it ain't. He said, yes, it is. Nigga, come with me. And both of y'all walked across the yard of the jail, and you walked up, and he was like, Daddy? He's like, nigga, what are you doing here? He said, nigga, what are you doing here? I told your ass never to come to jail. I told you never to come to jail. Is that a true story, Speedy?
He does have a son, Donald Caldwell.
Hilarious.
Is that true?
Hilarious.
Right, let me get a story.
I love this.
I heard this 2 days ago.
It's like 1989,
another summer.
It's like 1983, 84. So Wayside.
Okay.
I'm in Wayside. And I'm in the lower part and the upper part. And my boy said, Don Caldwell. I was like, yeah, here's another Don Caldwell up the thing. I was like,
looks just like that.
I said, go with that. He said, no, serious shit. This is another Don Caldwell. So I said, all right, let's roll up. We walk up to the hill.
You didn't know?
Nah. Because it's huge.
But hold on, nigga. You didn't know where your daddy was. Fuck that.
I didn't know he was there.
It was your dad?
I knew he was in jail. I didn't know.
I thought he was at home. Let me finish.
Nigga, he was at home.
So it was your dad.
Finish the story.
So it was your dad, not your son.
No, not my son. God, I said 83.
Speedy O's. I don't know.
Wow.
Donald was born in it.
I don't know how old
you didn't put a gunshot right when you call him old.
It was daddy.
So anyway, so I go up daddy there. Donald. And sure, it's my dad. I'm like, God damn. He's like, yeah, shit, motherfucking drinking and driving ain't no joke. So, nigga, I don't know.
Yes, sir.
It's a few motherfuckers. When you're on the yard, you go find you find a little buddy to hang with, so you niggas watch each other back. Yeah. It's me and my daddy.
How long were both of y'all there?
2 weeks. He was there for 2 weeks.
What were you there for?
Traffic tickets.
Wow. Because
they would send you the
Huh? Sounds like a bad sitcom.
The county, makes money off of you by sending you to Wayside.
Right, of course.
So you're at the county jail. They put you on the bus when you're about to get released. They put you on the Grey Goose, send you up there. They make about $5,000 off of you just driving you up there, and then can bring you right back.
Right.
So they'll send you up there. You'll chill for a couple weeks, and you come back and get released. So they go, like, well, you going up to Wayside? I'm like, God damn. Because you go up there, it's just like Cambodia and that motherfucker.
Right.
And so, but the weird shit is me and my dad walking around. So, you know, you can get yourself together. Yeah, yeah. Myself together. You go get yourself
together.
And welcome back to My Dad, My Soulmate.
My Dad, My Soulmate.
Yo,
have you ever talked about this on stage?
Nah. On Lifetime.
It's so weird.
You got to. It's hilarious. Like, for real, dude.
It's so weird that somebody told you that, because I like blocked all that shit out.
Oh, but no,
you should have seen your face, like, you just smile, like, oh, this is true. It's like,
what am I going to go?
Memory.
That never happened. No, if a motherfucker told you, God damn, who was that?
Don't worry, nah, I just heard.
One of y'all put on the David Banner music. I heard the
Hulk sad.
That's the Hulk sad.
That really fucking happened. And then we just walking around the yard. Show up.
My daddy and me.
What's today? Today's Monday? No, it was last night.
Let me tell you about my best friend. He's in jail, man. He's stopping from getting it in your butt, too. Why don't let it rape me? I got you, son.
How are you including your daddy in the ass raping? You said you're gonna ass rape me and my daddy? Man. No, I'm gonna ass rape you, nigga.
We share our cornbread too.
We family.
But you're over there playing with them lifers.
I don't like those new friends you've been hanging out with, the Aryans.
which really remind me of
the
story.
I don't like those friends, the Aryans. Speedy, don't bring that little Mexican boy by his cell no more. All how many times did I tell you clean the top bunk, Speedy? Oh, you just gonna get a tattoo tier two, huh? Cholo. I guess you won't be a cholo, huh?
It's Reach Around Radio. We have Anthony Anderson in the house and Marlon Wayans. The phone lines are open.
Good night, Daddy.
323.
You got a pretty mouth.
965-1600.
Good night, John Boy. Good night, Daddy. Good night, son.
Good night, Jose. Good night, Jose.
Good night, Jose.
It's Reach Around Radio. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back.
Oh, shit.
Like a cholo, all up in the club, 10 deep, looking for some highness. We on the creep, I need a bad one.